Destiny's Child single, Survivor het den. Ikke overraskende nok, de er tilbake igjen, og da er det en passende titel, ikke sant? Jeg har celebert besøk nå. Manic Street Preachers er i bua, folkens. For dere som kanskje ikke er helt fullstendig oppdatert på alt det gutta har gjort i musikkhistorien, så har jeg satt sammen en liten sånn greie med alle musikkvideoene. Følg med nå. Manic Street Preachers! Welcome, you guys.
Ooh. Hi, Dan. I just see myself on the telly. I look awful.
Yeah. I mean, that's normally how it goes.
You look good.
Looking back, thank you. I do?
Yeah, you look fine.
Welcome to the show. We had three chairs here. What's the third person?
Sean's lost his voice. No, he just never... He doesn't really do interviews, Sean.
Okay.
He's a drummer!
Of course.
Just keep him in the back. Like.
Okay. Where should we start? So much to talk about here. The new album. First of all, you guys came out with "This Is My Truth," and then you bring this one on. This is really back to the roots, right?
Yeah, I think so. It's definitely the spirit of why we started the group in the first place. You know, it's noisy and chaotic, and hopefully a bit exciting as well.
Yeah, but why the need to go back to the roots? I mean, you came out with. With "This Is My Truth," then you went number one, and what's so bad about fame?
Well, there's nothing wrong with fame. It's just I think if you do it for too long, you get caught in a bubble and you lose sense of reality perhaps. And sometimes it's important just to realize why you started a group in the first place.
Yeah.
To annoy people.
Is that why? Because I read in the Q magazine something about know your enemy, and one of you guys said that you have become your own enemy. Is that? Something in the way of the other album, or
I just think it's true of all people. It doesn't matter if it's your job. You know, there's a certain period in your life that you just look back and you try to think if you're still doing the right thing. And we just felt that we had to, we'd become as big as we could, and perhaps with this album we wanted to go in a different direction.
Mm-hmm. So that mean like you missed the underground feeling, or what?
I think we missed the feeling of just you know, not being scared of. You know, songs not being played on the radio and stuff like that. We missed the feeling of just sometimes people not liking us.
Okay.
Sometimes, you know, you get as much satisfaction from people hating you as people liking you. You know, and we're still quite childish in that way.
Mm-hmm. So, what can you tell me about this one? Know your enemy. Who's the enemy now?
So anyone who doesn't buy the record.
Okay.
So
I got this one for Frida's account.
Well, the jury's out on that one.
We'll you can slip we'll me some money after, time. Yeah?
Okay, thank you. There's a new single. Got it right here. Why So Sad? What? What's it about?
It's just about, you know, that feeling you have all your life that kind of like you're always searching something to actually believe in, but it's like the ongoing search that, like, you know, you never really stop. So kind of, that's why the song's got a bit of, like, sense of innocence about it. Mm-hmm. Like, you know, like, you've always got that feeling inside you that, like, you know, there's something, you know, the big thing you're kind of like, you know, left discovered to actually like, you know, give your life direction. You never actually find it.
I love the video. We're going to watch it now. So can you please just introduce it yourself?
This is So Why So Sad by S.
Check it out. So Why So Sad, Manic Street Preachers. Det er mange Manic Street Preachers fans som sitter der ute og ser på noe. Det vet jeg, for det hagler inn med spørsmål til gutta. Vi skal ta det om en liten stund. What's that all about, man? Throwing hand grenades at kids and stuff?
It's not that at all. It's just a very sensitive video, really, on about, you know, sometimes you don't really notice what's going on in the world, you know.
That's right.
It's that California dream, you know, as long as you've got a suntan, nothing else matters. So it's just a criticism of that, really.
Okay. So in California, was it shot in California?
Some of it was in LA. We didn't go to LA. We just did our bit in London.
Okay.
We couldn't be bothered to get the flight.
Okay. Too much bullets and hand grenades in the video.
Exactly. Yeah.
All right. Get it.
Too much sun.
Too much sun. Okay. As far as the album, is it pretty much back to politics and do you keep changing subjects as normal?
Yeah, I just think, you know, the album is just, yeah, just much more instinctive. We're riding our instincts a bit more. Mm-hmm. And kind of like, you know, yeah, there's some kind of, you know, some politics on the album, definitely, and, you know, but not all of it is completely angry and negative. There's some, this rays of light on there.
Some of it's just rock and roll, you know.
Yeah.
If we strip everything away, we're always just an energetic rock and roll punk band.
Mm-hmm.
Sometimes it's just the lyrics, like, have a bit more meaning to them, you know.
Right. For dere som ikke visste det, så har Manic Street Preachers nylig vært på Cuba for å spille musikk. Cuba er litt mer enn sjokolade, folkens, for dere som trodde det. Vi skal se litt på hva som skjedde i Cuba. Manic Street Preachers på Cuba. Cuba, guys. How was Castro?
Castro is a very cool man. He's very funny, very warm, very witty. Just okay. Like probably the most charismatic person we've ever met, obviously.
Mm-hmm. Yeah? But how was it playing there?
It was a brilliant experience. You know, we wanted to go somewhere totally new. We'd never been there before. No one knew us. We don't sell any records. It was just, it was like starting over again, trying to convert 5,000 people to like you. You know, it was just a real challenge.
Mm-hmm.
And it just, that made it really exciting.
How important for you guys was it to actually play in Cuba? I mean, for what it stands for politically and everything.
Well, I think it was just about us giving something back, really, and just showing that there are people who respect Cuban culture, not just the political side of it, but the whole idea that it kind of stood up against America. And I don't know, it was just us giving something back. We, you know, we just felt some kind of affinity. Just a nice feeling, you know. We lost loads of money. Sony doesn't trade over there, you know. So it was just all down to us. It was nice to do something like that.
Okay, sounds good. There's a lot of viewers out there, and since this is a public show, we thought it would be nice for the audience to be able to ask you guys some questions, if that's okay.
Yeah.
Okay. We covered some of this on the first part, but Know Your Enemy is rougher. This is Anders. Know Your Enemy is rougher and less polished than a previous album, I think. Did you feel the need to distance yourself from the previous album, and why?
I think, you know, kind of the new record just sounded a bit rougher. It's just like the sound of us having kind of our kind of own kind of fun. It's just, that's just us having more fun, basically. So,
okay.
Yeah, it was intentional, but it just came from us just being more spontaneous.
Okay. Gabby from Tromsø asks, do you reckon your gig in Cuba met your expectations?
Yeah, the concert itself really did. It was a really bizarre experience. You know, some people were headbanging, some people were disco dancing, and some people fell asleep. It was just a completely mad experience, but that's what we wanted. So it lived up to all our expectations, yeah.
Good, good. Trine Pleim Sandvik from Oslo asks, what did Castro think about your music? Did you get a chance to ask him that?
Well, he compared Sean's drumming to the artillery. So he was like, all night you play the drums, boom, 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 boom. So kind of, I think that's the only thing he actually said about it, that we were louder than war, and he compared the drums to the artillery. So it's a pretty good review, we think.
Okay, that's good. So what kind of music do you listen to yourselves? What's your music idols? Knut Eivind Strømme from Kløfta.
Loads of stuff, you know. I think the Sex Pistols and the Clash were the main inspiration, but also the Smiths and Echo and the Bunnymen, early Who, early Rolling Stones,
Public Enemy
as
well.
Enemy,
massive influence.
Public Enemy.
Yeah.
Okay. Is punk still alive?
No.
Nope?
No, I think, to be honest, I mean, the spirit of punk may be alive, but it's in different forms of music now. It's in the idea of expression and adventure. I don't think punk music, certainly if you're talking about American bands, you know, Offspring, Green Day and all that, that's not punk for me. That's
it's
just
not, it
kind
isn't.
Of corporate American rubbish.
Yeah? Okay. As far as shows, we'll be seeing you guys in Norway soon.
Yeah, we're doing the Court Festival.
You're doing the Court Festival?
Yeah. Indeed.
Dere hørte det først her på Vegardistad. Tup tju, nå sier jeg igjen. Manic Street Preachers kommer til Kortfestivalen, folkens. That'd be good.
Yeah, we've never done it before, so we're really looking forward. But lots of drunken Norwegians, we're told.
Just like going to the Mediterranean in the summertime,
actually. Yeah.
So what do you think about festivals in general?
I think European ones are much more enjoyable. There's less pressure, more relaxed atmosphere, really. Mm-hmm. Back home, it's a lot of pressure if you're headlining. It's a lot of media and a lot of pressure, but in Europe, it's really enjoyable.
Looking forward to seeing you in a Court Festival then. Mine damer og herrer, kjempeapplaus for Manic Street Preachers! Nice to see you guys to come.
Thanks a lot.
Thanks for coming.
Thank you.
Vi skal over på den andre nykommeren.